Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
National Interest this week looks at a new strategic threat that India had better worry about. And what is peculiar about this threat? One, this is not military. This has nothing to do with any new forces Pakistan may have moved across the LOC. It has nothing to do with this ridiculous missile test that Pakistan keeps carrying out to get some headlines and maybe to shore up their own morale in times of tension or maybe to distress themselves. This does not come from any of our traditional adversaries anywhere. This comes, one, from within. Second, it's economic. And third, what it threatens is not our borders or not our people directly, because it doesn't even come from a terror group. It threatens our global goodwill, because this is something that I said once in Cut the Clutter and I'll say it again. When your economy is growing at 8%, as India's was for a long time, particularly for a long time in periods of tensions with Pakistan, at 8% growth, the world gives you the license of Saat Khoon Maaf. You can get away with 7 murders. It's a Hindi metaphor that I'm twisting into English. Comes down to 7% growth, maybe it's 5 Khoon Maaf. First, 8% Saat Khoon Maaf. 7%, you can get away with 5 murders. But once you come down to 5, you are in a dodgy zone. You better be a law-abiding global citizen. And if it's fall lower than that, then if you are not a law-abiding global citizen all the time, then the world comes and arm twists you. That's the way the modern world works. Do we have any evidence to show it? I will tell you. 91 to 94 was the toughest period for India in Kashmir. That is what I always call the heather phase in Kashmir's history. That is the history of Kashmir that Vishal Bhardwaj portrayed in his film Heather. That's when torture chambers were there, crackdowns were being carried out all the time, army was present everywhere, hundreds, literally thousands of people were being killed, pandits were expelled at that time, all kinds of awful things happened then. So 91 to 94, India came under great international pressure. That is when the Human Rights Commission also took up a case against India. It was a very difficult situation. India had a weak government, had a minority government, but not weak in a sense. So this was the period also when mostly India, or Narasimha Rao, who was the Prime Minister, dealt with Clinton in his first presidency, in his first term. And at that point, Clinton's America was very hostile to India. Clinton was very hostile. His administration was very hostile. In fact, there is still that scar of his Assistant Secretary of State in charge of this region, Robin Riffle, questioning the validity or legality of the instrument of accession of Kashmir. Then something happened, and dramatically, the same Bill Clinton and Clinton administration changed its view of India diametrically in Clinton's second term. So what is it that had happened between the first term and the second term? What had happened was that Narasimha Rao, in his only term, because he only served for one term, started economic reform in 91. By 92, 93, 94, India's economy had begun to grow. It was an economic growth on the upswing. India became a place which was welcoming of investment, foreign entrepreneurship, foreign brands, foreign ideas. And more Indian talent and Indian ingenuity now began to be displayed around the world. So India became a country in which the world acquired a stake. And then this then carried on. India built on this strength, and you can then see, you can plot every crisis that India had. Was it the parliament attack? Was it after that 26/11? Every such crisis you found increasingly that the world weighed in on India's side unanimously, and in fact mostly upbraided or admonished Pakistan. The Chinese may not have admonished Pakistan, but they behaved in a way that India would never have expected them to behave. So what is the explanation? Explanation is economic growth, India being the new flavor of the season for the whole world. Look, if the Chinese built a $60 billion trade surplus with India, selling a lot of manufactured goods, but a whole lot of rubbish also that no one else would buy. That's because Indian consumers had the spare cash to buy more. All of that came from growth. So this way, every country acquired a vested interest in India's stability, and nobody wanted India harmed. Look at Britain now. India now is very impatient and very irritated with Britain because of the position they took in the UN Security Council, and then a couple of statements from high UK officials saying human rights, this and that, you guys look after yourselves, and then the kind of protests at the Indian High Commission, which the UK government has not been able to protect fully. The same Britain was four square behind India in that decade and a half of growth. In fact, the expression four square, I first heard used in public debate by Tony Blair, who came to India as Prime Minister, and he said, on the issue of terrorism, we stand four square behind India. In fact, I had not seen that expression used before. Why was that happening? Remember, it was in that period that one Indian corporate group, one conglomerate, acquired two of Britain's largest companies, Jaguar Land Rover and Corus, the steel maker, and became the largest private sector job provider in Britain. So that is how your economic strength becomes your strategic strength. In the modern world, wars are passé. Your strategic strength comes from other things. So this rising or a growing economy brings you more clout than any mega tonnage of nuclear weapons or any size of any army. That is where India has now begun to slip up. Four quarters have shown a decline. Doesn't look like the next couple will be an improvement. And as that happens, the same world which looked so kindly at India and which frankly indulged India in so many ways now begin to ask tougher questions. So India is now beginning to lose a strategic advantage. For India to prevent that from happening and to also recover this, India has to focus on the economy and restore growth back.